Good morning dear students. In today's lecture of maths we are going to learn about the multiplication and division of irrational numbers. In yesterday's lecture we have seen the addition, how to do the addition and the subtraction of irrational numbers, in which we have seen that we can add two irrational numbers whose irrational factors are same. Correct? Let us see how to multiply first. How to multiply the irrational numbers, or which irrational numbers can be multiplied. See, the first rule is irrational number of same order are multiplied. Irrational numbers of same order are multiplied. Here the word order is important. As in the addition, which word was important? Irrational factor. Okay? Similarly, here in the multiplication, which word is important? Order. Irrational numbers of same order are multiplied. Means, say, now this, what is mean by this order? Yesterday I have told you order means what? See, this is what? Radical sign. It is called radical sign. Okay? Two radical signs are there, suppose. Here there is number 3. Means it is called cube. That's why this sign is called now cube root. And here also, if there is 3, that means this is also cube root. Inside the number is 27, here 81, whichever. Okay? So in these 3 represent the order of this integer, order of this irrational number. The number inside the cube root is called integer, positive integer it should be. Okay? This number, this 3, here also 3, that is cube. So this is cube root, here also cube root. That means what? Order of this irrational number is 3. Order of this irrational number is 3. Okay? If it is like this, then what is order of this irrational number? It is not written here. Generally the number which is written here, it is called order of that irrational number, but here it is not written. That means what is the order of this irrational number? Its order is 2. Here also 2. Correct? If it is written here 4, 4th root of 81, then order of this irrational number is 4. Okay, this. So it can be second order of third order means cube root, fourth root, fifth root, sixth root, seventh root, whatever. Then to multiply any two irrational numbers, their orders must be same. Here order is 3, here also order must be 3. Then only these numbers under root or under that, in that radical sign, can be multiplied. Understood? If order is 3 and 2, then these numbers cannot be multiplied directly. We have to do the modification. Okay, directly we cannot multiply these numbers. If their orders are same, then these numbers can multiply. Understood? So this tells the this is the meaning of the first rule, that irrational numbers of same order can be multiplied. Okay, understood this rule? Second is, if the irrational numbers to be multiplied are not of the same order. Now that also I have told you. If the irrational numbers, two irrational numbers which we are going to multiply, if they are not of same order, if their order is not same, then what to do? First, reduce them to the same order. We have to make their order same. And to make their order same, which way we have to find the LCM of the given order, and we have to make both order of both the irrational numbers equal. That we will learn while doing the multiplication. Okay, now see. Let us see the first example. Square root of 5 into square root of 7. Okay, here if you see order of these two irrational numbers, it is not written here. That means what is order? 2. Means it is square root. So square root of 5 into square root of 7. Their order is same. That means this example belongs to the first rule. Okay. So if order is same, we can multiply directly. 5 into 7, that is square root of 35. It is easy. When their orders are same, we can multiply the integers inside that radical sign directly. See second one. What is second one example? Cube root of 12 into cube root of 5. This also comes, belongs to the first rule. Their orders are same, 3, 3. What is orders? 3 and 3. That's why this example belongs to the first rule. So, if the orders are same, we can multiply the numbers inside that radical sign directly. 12 into 5. That is cube root of 12 5s are 16. Understood? Then see third one. Fourth root of 32 into fourth root of 8. Okay, here also both the irrational numbers have same order, that is 4, correct? So if order is same, that's why we can multiply the numbers. 32 into 8. That is 8 to the 16, 1 carry, 8 to the 16, 1 carry, 8 to the 24 and 1, 25, 256. Okay, so fourth root of 256. This is the answer. Now see, example number 4. Cube root of 5 into square root of 2. See, cube root of 5 into square root of 2. Can we multiply these irrational numbers directly? Can we multiply these irrational numbers directly? No, because their orders are not same. Here, order of this irrational number is 3. Order of this irrational number is 2 square. Okay? So, directly we cannot multiply. So, what we have to do first? We have to make their order same. And how to make their order same? By finding LCM of these orders. See, the orders of both irrational numbers are 3 and 2. Orders are 3 and 2. Means this 3 and here square root is 2. Not these two. This is square root. That means here order is 2, which is invisible. Okay? So order is 3 and 2. So to make the order equal, we have to find the LCM. LCM of the order. So what is LCM of 3 and 2? 3 and 2. LCM is 6. That means what? We have to make the order equal to 6. Okay? So let us do the necessary changes. 3 multiplied by how many 2? 3 2s are. Now see what we are going to do. Here there was 3. To make here 6, we need to multiply by 2. 3 2s are 6. At the same time, here also there will be change. Inside the cube root there is 5. So since we have multiplied the order by 2, that's why here also we have to write the exponent of 5. Second exponent of 5. Okay? So it will be 5 raised to the 2. Understood? Why these 2 came here? Because we have multiplied to make the order equal to 6. We have multiplied this 3 by 2. That's why we have to write the second exponent of 2 or square of 5. Sorry, not 2, 5. Okay? Multiply by. Now see here. Here, as it is square root, that's why its order is 2. To make here 6, we need to multiply by 3. That's why the number inside, we need to write its exponent 3. Okay? Is equal to 3 2s are now 6. 5 raised to 2. What is 5 to 2? 5 raised to 2? 5 into 5. Into 3 2s are 6. And 2 raised to the power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2.
is equal to 6. 5 5s are 25. 6th root of 25 into 6 root of 2 to the 4 to the 8. Okay. So now see, both the irrational numbers have same order, 6, 6 and 6. Okay. So we can multiply these numbers inside this root. 25 into 8, that is 6th root of 25 is 200. This is your answer.
What we have done, have you understood? See, the example is cube root of 5 into square root of 2. Since their orders are not same, here order is 3, here order is 2. Since their orders are not same, so we cannot multiply the numbers directly. That's why first we have found the LCM of their order. And whatever LCM we have got, we have convert that order into the equal to the LCM. Okay. So here we have made 6 by multiplying here 2 and here by 3. And since we have multiplied here by 2, so same number we have to write in the exponent of the number which is inside the sign. Here we have multiplied by 3, that's why here third exponent. Okay. And then we have gone through the first rule, according to the first rule. Then see here example number 5. 5 into square root of 32 into multiply by 2 into cube root of 81. Okay. Now see here. First forget about these numbers 5 and 2 that we can multiply. Now see, here the irrational number is root, square root of 32 and here cube root of 81. So we let us first think about these irrational numbers. Their orders are not same. Here order is 3, here order is 2. Okay, so their orders are not same. That's why we need to make their order same to multiply, to get them multiplied. Otherwise, we cannot multiply directly. So before making their order same, now see here the number 32 and 81, these are quite bigger number. So as we have done in the addition and subtraction, first let us find the simplest form. Anyhow, after finding and final answer, we need to find simplest form if we do not find here. Okay, so it is difficult to find simplest form at the end. That's why first find the simplest form if possible. Now here already these numbers are in the lowest term, in the simplest form. That's why we have not found the simplest form here. But here this 32, square root of 32 and cube root of 81, then we can find the simplest form. Let us see. Let us take this first number, 5 square root of 32. Now how to find simplest form, I have told you yesterday. As this is under square root, correct? Square root. That's why find the factors of 32 in such a way that one number should be square number. So you know that 5, 32 is what? 16 twos are, and 16 is square number here. Okay? So 5, 16 is square of 4, 4 square into 2. So under root 4 square means its value is 4, correct? Means square root of 16 is 4, that's why I take that out. It will be multiplied with this 4, 5, and in the square root remain 2. Under the square root remain 2. That is, at the end we have got 5, 4 is 20, under square root 2. Okay? Take the second number, second irrational number 2 into cube root of 81. Now here, while finding the simplest form, while converting this into simplest form, as this is cube root, that's why find the factors of 81 in such a way that one number out of two, one number should be cube number. Okay? Now see. You know, 27 threes are 81, and in that 27 is cube number. 27 is cube of 3, correct? So that's why I have taken the 27 threes are. So because 27 is a cube number. So 2 into
27 is cube of 3 into 3. So this cube of 3 means this cube root of 27 is 3, that will take out, it will be multiplied with this 2. And inside the cube root remains this 3. So it is 3 2s are 6 under cube root 3. This is the second number we have got after finding the simplest form. Okay. Now here our example doesn't finish. Still, let us see now 20 under square root into under square root 2 multiplied by 6 under cube root 3. Now we have to multiply them, but again their orders are not same. First we have found the simplest form, then see now, since their orders are not same, their here order is 2, here order is 3. Okay, so since their orders are not same, so first we need to make their order same. And how to make the order same? By finding their LCM. So the orders of both the irrational numbers are 3 and 2, correct? 2 here, 3 and here 2. So their LCM is, LCM of 2 and 3 is 6 again. Okay? So we need to make here 6. It is, there is 2, means it is square root, that's why there is 2. So to make here 6, we need to multiply by 3. That's why here also cube of 2. Okay? Multiply by here 6 into, there is 3. To make here 6, we need to multiply by 2. And inside there is 3. As we multiply by 2, that's why square of 3. Okay? So we get here 20. 6th root of cube of 2 is 8 into 6 into 6th root of square of 3 is 9. Now the orders are same, here 6, here 6. So we can multiply them. Multiply these numbers 20 and 6, rational numbers and irrational numbers under the 6th root. Okay, what we have done? This rational numbers 20 and 6 we have multiplied separately, and these irrational numbers we have multiplied separately. Okay, so 26 are 120, and here 6th root of 8, 9 are 72. So answer is 120 into 6th root of 72. This is our final answer. Okay, so in this way we can multiply the two irrational numbers. Two rules, just you have to keep it in mind. Irrational numbers of same order are multiplied, and if the irrational numbers which are to be multiplied are not of same order, then first we need to make their order same by finding the LCM, and then we have to multiply it. Okay? Pause this video now here and write these examples in your notebook. After that, we will see the division of the irrational numbers. Now let's see the division of the irrational numbers. Division is also same like multiplication of irrational numbers. The rules are same. Irrational numbers of same order are divided by the division law. Division law means an identity which I have given to you yesterday. It is like this. Under root a upon b is equal to under root a divided by under root b. Means if their orders are same, then these numbers can be divided. Okay, this is the division law. And the first one was multiplication law, that why we have seen while doing the multiplication. Now see, irrational numbers of same order are divided as irrational numbers of same order are multiplied. Similarly, irrational numbers of same order are divided. Okay, this is the first one. If their order is same, then only the numbers inside the radical sign can be divided. Okay. Now, second rule is if the irrational numbers which we are going to divide, if their orders are not same, then what we have to do? We cannot divide directly. We have to make their order same, reduce their order same, and then we have to divide. Okay. First, we have to make their order same and then we have to divide, okay? Same as multiplication. See the first example. 4 into square root of 28 divide by 3 square root of 7. This is the example. So first, let us write this example in this way. Divide by, okay, the 4 and 3, these are not order, these are rational numbers here. Okay, this 4 is multiplied with this under root of 28. Similarly, 3 is multiplied with this under root of 7. Okay, these are not order. What is order of this irrational number? It is here. What is that? Not return. That means what is that? 2. So in both the irrational numbers, their orders are same. That's why this example belongs to the first rule. Now their orders are same, that's why we can divide the numbers inside the sign. Okay, so it can be written as 4 upon 3 under root 28 upon 7. Okay, now these numbers we can divide. 7 under 7, 7, 4 is 28. So 4 upon 3 under root 4. Now see here what extension you can do further. This is square root of 4, and we know the square root of 4, as 4 is a square number. That's why square root of 4 is 4 upon 3 into square root of 4 is 2. Right? Because 4 is the square of 2, that's why square root of 4 is 2. So 4 times 8 upon 3 is the answer. It's very easy. If the orders are same, then the division and multiplication is very easy. See the second example. 9th root of 8 divided by 6th root of 6. Now here there is division of these two numbers, but if you observe, here the order is 9, here order is 6. Their orders are not same, okay? So first we have to make their order equal by finding the LCM. Let us find the LCM of the order 9 and 6. So LCM of 9 and 6 is, what is that? LCM of 9 and 6, 18, correct? 9 is 18, 6 is 18. So that means what we have to make here, or order here 18 and here also 18. So let us do that changes. 9 multiplied by how many 18? 2 is all. So since you have multiplied here by 2, that's why we need to write here exponents of 8 as a 2. Divide by 6 multiplied by how many? 6 3 is all. So 3rd power of 6. 9 2 is 18. 18th root of, what is square of 8? 8 is 64. Divide by 6 3 is 18. 18th root of cube of 6. What is cube of 6? 6 6 is 36. 36 6 is 216. Okay. Now their orders are same. 18 18. That's what we can do. Divide them according to the division law. 18 64 divided by 18th root of 216, which is equal to 18th root of 64 divided by 216. Can you find its reduced term? 64 and 216, they are divisible by which number? They are divisible by 8. 8 into 64, 8 1 the 2 the 16, 7 the 56. Okay, so 8 upon 27 is the answer. 18th root of 8 upon 27 is the answer. Okay, so what we have done here by dividing, here orders were not same, that's why we found first LCM of their orders, that is LCM of 9 and 6, which is 18, and then we have done the changes accordingly. And then we have divided. Okay. Next, third one. 6th root of 12 divide by square root of 3 into third root of or cube root of 2. Now see here, there is division also and here there is multiplication. So first, let us do the multiplication of these two numbers. Do the multiplication. Of square root of 3 and cube root of 2. Now to do this multiplication, we have to use the rules of multiplication which we have seen earlier, and they are the same like these two rules. Okay, so we have seen square root of 3 into cube root of 2. Their orders are not same. Their order is 2, square root means it is 2. Their order is 3, that's why their orders are not same, that's why we do not multiply directly. So let us first find LCM of 2 and 3 to make the order equal. And you know the LCM of 2 and 3 is nothing but 6. So here 2 into, to convert 2 into 6, we need to multiply by 3. So here also exponent of 3, we need to write 3. Multiply by 3 2's are, since we have multiplied this 3 by 2, so here we need to write its power of 2. 3 2's are 6, 6 root of cube of 3 is 27 into 3 2's are 6, 6 root of square of 2 is 4. Okay, now we can multiply as their orders are same. We can multiply them. So 6 root of 27 into 4, which is equal to 6 root of 27 4s are. What is 27 4s are? 108. Okay? 108. So 6 root of 108. This is the answer of this multiplication. Now let us come back again to the division. 6 root of 12 divided by 6 root of 108, and surprisingly see, we have got the same order, that's why directly we can divide. So 6 root of 12 divided by 6 root of 12 divided by 6 root of 108. Since their orders are same, directly we can divide 6 root of 12 divided by 108. And you know 12 on the 12, 12 9's are 108, so 6 root of 1 by 9 is the answer. So in this way, we have to perform the division of two irrational numbers. Multiplication and division, both the rules are same. Okay. What is first rule? Irrational numbers of same order can be multiplied or divided if, second rule is if, the order of two irrational numbers are not same, then we first have to make them same and then we have to multiply or divide. And while making the order same, what changes we have to do? That I have shown you through these examples. If you have any doubt in this, you are free to ask. So thank you for today. Have a nice day.